Hello, and welcome back to Conarium. Conarium? Conarium. Welcome back, either way. We have fumbled around a lot of nonsense here, and just a lot of bad things. Alright, again, let's just jump right in. I really didn't want to come down here. I hate basements. Let's open both these up, though. Is this the... I can see my breath. How is this tree here? At least, how is it green? It's stuck. Interesting. I'm glad it does not open. Oh, okay, alright, here we go again. Okay, alright. Less crazy as it was the first time. Still kills my heart a little bit, but that's fine. Alright, might as well check all four. Looking for keys of some sort. Let's see. Professional camp equipment. We're delayed to deploy to the underground caverns below the base. Yeah, I figured as much. Submarines. Ooh. Oh no, they went to the underwater passages. No. Oh no. So the book itself went over the, you know, this expedition party going to the Antarctic, finding these mounds of madness, it more or less by chance. And once again, digging in and finding all of these tunnels and everything, more or less by chance. Oh, these are the fungus, yeah? In any case, when they did that, they found, oh, the crank! Hell yeah. Oh, that's a mistake. Oh, kitty! Hi! You're adorable. I don't understand why people would find you so fucking, you know, disturbing. You are adorable. I'd pet you if I could. Why is this beeping? Aww, got big old cat ears. This is a mistake. Oh, good. Well, I guess I'll die. Cat? Okay, cool. Oh, because I picked up the radio. That's a bit of a butt. In any case, so the story goes that they found these bodies, the pictures that you saw before, of these species. Oh, come on now, cat. Oh. Can we say no, please, Keycat? Keycat, you okay? Oh. I don't think he gets okay. It's fine though, it's fine. I really wish I could close that. Everything's so fucking dark. I am a bit worried. What was the quick save? Options. Game controls. Is that a 5, right? Yeah, it was. Cool. I guess I'll fucking die then. Kitty cat, listen. Listen. Listen, it's not very nice. Oh, that's not super great. I'm gonna shut this. Uh-oh. Uh-oh. Oh no. What is happening? Am I... Oh, down. Awesome. Cool. I'm probably gonna need to go upstairs and get some, you know, medicine for myself for that nonsense. Holy crap. Oh, yep. I believe this is one of them. In any case, he found these species here. Yeah, with the legs and everything. It should have wings and some sort of starish top on there.
These are the pre-human species we found frozen in a cave far south of the base.
Yeah, it's supposed to have like a star-like head with eyes on each point or something like that. Yes.
These are the pre-human species we found frozen in a cave far south of the base.
Yeah, so these are supposed to have, like, wings and shit like that. And, well, they might have evolved on this one. They might be showing a different one. However, they found those, and... Okay, I thought I saw like a shadow. They brought them out to, the site that they had made nearby. And of course, this was Team 1, and there was a couple other teams on two of the ships that you saw. And one of them that was trying to catch up to this other group that found all of these amazing discoveries. They had done so when they had first originally done so. One of the now main team was on the ship listening to the doctor's discovery and describing it all and cutting it open and all of that good stuff.
So much decomposition.
Oh, nice. A key. Thank you. Oh, no. Oh, let's see. God damn it. We have finally finished evacuating the monolith that was silently waiting for a soul to see it again. Situated within the circular building we reached with the link elevator. That magnificent piece of carving was buried halfway down under a mound of debris and almost probably could have been written in the earliest pages of history. I cannot describe exactly my feelings for the first time when I stood aghast contemplating that gigantic stonework inside of those time-worn halls of silence. Only God knows how many ages have passed since the initial carving. Just thinking about its age sends shivers down my spine. Which civilization could have constructed such grandeur? Now waving a forlorn goodbye without giving away any secrets of its masters. Furthermore, even though most of them were damaged beyond repair, we spotted some symbols resembling the rock art of the Sahara Desert in southeast Algeria. We don't have any strong evidence to suggest anything, but Cornwell Blake clings mostly to the continental drift theory. In any case, we don't have enough data on its age, but it is evident that history needs to be rewritten once again. Which makes perfect sense. So yeah, like I was saying before, this original research team that had done this discoveries found these ancient beings, this ancient things. Oh, now I can't remember. Great, good going, me. Disappeared overnight. Their dogs, their tents, people were murdered, and just good. Oh, good, there it is. It's definitely this. Yep. Oh yeah, see, there's the wings on the back. There's a
no more can we harbor ourselves on the safest shores, for there are things that cannot be undone. I think you should retire to your room. I'm going to think a bit more.
Okay. Oh yeah, yeah, these are the wings. They were supposed to be like eyes on top of there. It's that weird plant. Globe. Antarctic, yeah. Possibly the map they used, and once again, the Antarctic. Alright, I guess I will retire to the room. In any case, trying to continue to jump back on this nonsense. Everybody of the first expedition died. When the second expedition got there, it was a complete and utter disaster mess. Everybody was torn to pieces, all that nonsense. And some of the bodies of these ancient things were buried in these weird mounds. Some of them were in fact missing, so assuming that they came back to life and murdered everybody, but it doesn't really tell you that, obviously. Try the story real quick. Yeah, I figured. And as the second team comes in, like I said, now the main team, because everybody else died. What is that? Let me guess. Alright. Hit me. They try to collect as much evidence as they possibly can. In a nutshell, two people go up into the mountain, and they go right down all of these discoveries, and they find themselves inside these tunnels that lead to some sort of ancient weird ass village of this weird ass civilization, with some pictures of like these guys fighting. I think they made Shoggoths their slaves, and then there was an uprising. Divers. The legendary drink of the oldest myths. I heard about that elusive mixture decades ago when I was writing my thesis on Salvia Divinorium, also known as the Sage of the Diviners. Alright. An ethogenic plant used mostly in religious or shamanic. Anyways, ceremonies. For centuries, no one could gather any information about it other than its legendary, mythical, psychoactive properties. In some sources, it was the drink of the gods, while in others, a key to opening gates to places that lie beyond the conventional human senses. The sole bridge to be passed in order to leave the bodily restrictions of the flesh. Most scholars would kill even for a hint of one of these lost ingredients. That's something I was on the lookout for throughout my career. A new formula is forming in my mind. I feel like there's a chance for me to produce, if not the original, then a variant of the legendary mixture, Divrush, with new clues I have uncovered during my work here. That's cool. Shouldn't be diving into these kind of shit, but you know. Pronunciation of the diseases? Interesting. This is a thing. Handle of some sort. In any case, they went into the city of these guys here. I found a bunch of stuff saying that, you know, they made the Shoggoths as their slaves. Then there was an uprising, and then there was a lot of fighting, and then nonsense. They had multiple cities. Because these guys were originally, though they can walk on land, they seem to be better suited for swimming in the ocean. So, the theory was, or based on the maps that they found in the caves below, I'm assuming, that there were three other cities. One of them deep in the ocean, one of them kind of in the middle between the two, and then one of them on land. The one on land was abandoned. One of the ocean, and they couldn't get to the one in the ocean before they decided to run, because I believe they ran into a Shoggoth. And they're like, oh, hell no, and they ran away as fast as they fucking could, which is understandable. And being of a lot less sanity after running into one of those, they ran home. Oh, and then there's... Yeah, no, I missed this. Oh, fuck. Am I missing something here? What the fuck is going on? Why is my light out?
Right. I don't know if you can hear me, but...
Huh, so am I, is it, because I died? Am I in?
Hey, can you hear me? Damn it. Who was he?
Am I because I'm some sort of, am I actually some sort of ghost and like going through this, going through this place as some sort of, ghost, so all of these things are, like, happening with, oh, good. What's going on here? Link elevator has been set up, oh, fuck. How about we go up? Go up first. And we'll go down into the depths. However, that was the thing. So when I said that they had some sort of submarine and go to the middle of the ocean, that's kind of why I was just like, oh shit, because I'm not 100% sure if there was anything actually there. And if they did find something there, then, oh boy, they were absolutely fucked, because the skin of these guys were, like, extremely... Oh, hell yeah, what is this? This looks like... screw of some sort. God, now what? A few lights. Oh! Who are you? Oh, there we go.
This is amazing.
So they are
most
history.
Of the ground level structures have been crumbled
fragments.
And rounded from untold eons of savage storms, and thus weathered into shapeless ruins. However, both the ground level and the cavern systems below are clearly displayed in these bas reliefs. The most striking features depicted in this grand panorama, I believe, are the tall, occasional towering spires, which somehow resemble a lighthouse. They all seem like focusing a light beam towards a colossal structure in the center. Hmm. there be some sort of religious meaning behind this? Or simply something that has a more practical...
No, they weren't religious. They were scientists. They were actually very smart, just to kind of follow up on that. That's kind of what they ended up finding. They were very, very smart. They had things that were... I mean, they originally came from the ocean, where if there was... The whole thing was like, oh, yeah, no... no humans or anything were alive yet. They came at the very, very beginning. They had dominating the ocean, blah, blah, blah. Then they came on land. The point is that they had, like, space heaters and, like, actual built homes and electricity. I mean, it was very warped, and it looks, you know, like any kind of Lovecraftian thing was, but it was, definitely cool and interesting to read. A little bit less horror and a little more, just more interesting. However, these things weren't, they've added some things, obviously. I don't think that's supposed to be exactly it, but... Okay, alright.
So, this is the strong light that can be seen from ground level.
I do have a crank. Am I leaving footprints? Hold up. Are these my footprints? Oh. I am leaving footprints. That's cool. I don't know what this crank is for, though. I'd love to figure it out, but... seeing any place for it. It looks like it moves back and forth. I'm assuming this one's probably set up correctly. Interesting. So I gotta go around and turn those on. So this might be a little bit of a longer game than I thought it was going to be. I thought this was going to be a short and sweet one. However, we got that. Let's go down then. Let's go down a couple levels, see where that gets us. Yeah, so that was why I was just so like, oh shit, they've got submarines and now they're adding into the ocean. I'm like, that's not a good idea. To be fair, none of it is a good idea, but... I also touch things I'm not supposed to, so here we are. But like I said, like I was saying before, I do absolutely enjoy, I did enjoy that, you know, story a lot. It was definitely a lot, you know, a lot different from, like, the color space or all the other kind of stuff, things that we did where you thoroughly get kind of thrown into madness, where it's a lot more research. Ooh, a fucking axe, fuck yeah. There is some strange vegetation filling most of the hallways. As amazing as it is deadly, there is a hidden world right beneath the uphold base. And even though I was prepared to find such a place, it was way different than imagining alone. We tried to cut our way through, but the plant reacted with a highly poisonous gas, which I have already inhaled. Seemingly coming from its glowing buds, I issued a warning to stop everyone going near any of these plants they came across in any of those caverns. I also noticed a strange phenomenon after I spent some time examining a sample from the plant. It occurred to me that the individual vines grow and shrink in length on demand. It also seems as though it can move, even though there are no air currents. And its movement seems too regular to be caused by natural factors. This may sound strange, but I have a notion that it is conscious, at least on some level. No, I believe that, and there was a cat, and I fucked everything up.
Hey!
No one's fucking here.
Dr. James? Dr. Morgan?
Nobody's here, dude. Not even sure if you're here, so... these are some, like, these, you know, make perfect sense. Why is that there? That shouldn't be there. Anyways. It's definitely interesting, like some sort of... Can I move that? Oh, cool, I love... I love the kind of, like, tentacle-ish kind of design they have going on. Am I the one making those crick-crack noises? Yeah, I have no idea why that would be there. It doesn't make any sense why it would. I don't believe, if I'm correct, that it's Love... I don't think it's Lovecraft's sign either. Hello. I have a crank. Did you know that? I'm not exactly sure where this needs to be aiming, actually. Hold up. Give me a second. Alright, this is where these are. Oh. Maybe? Let's turn it one more time. Yes. Can I take my key back? No. Well, fuck me then. So I do absolutely enjoy the fact of this, you know, past history. Oh, this is gonna, you know, snap up in my face and face hugger the shit out of my but some of these things definitely don't make sense, and I'm sure some of you kind of know what I'm talking about, the humanoid structures here. There were no mention of them in the book. The only other creatures that were here were, that I was told about, were the giant penguins, which I was kind of hoping to see. Not sure if I will, but heck, who wouldn't want to see monstrous fucking penguins? What is this? This is kind of carved out. It does remind me of lizards, so lizard men of some sort. So I'm gonna go with my first theory, like, oh, the lizard men came in and found this place, and then they took the thought that it was okay for them to come in and fucking place all their own shit up in here. Maybe they died for it. This might be the Shoggoth. They might have befriended him. I feel like I'm going deeper without any kind of knowledge about going back. What do we got going on over here? Okay, alright. This was a mistake. Why do I keep doing this to myself? I guess we're just gonna go in his lap anyways. No? Fucking what the fuck is going on?
What was that?
I don't know. I didn't see anything. Did you see something? Because I fucking missed it. That makes me sad. Oh, there's a lizard ass. Good lizard ass. Alright, fuck me. I can't believe I fucking missed that. Ugh, this fucking pissed me off. Alright. Fuck, I gotta do a little search around the room. What the... The fuck is that? fuck, I think it's just the lag of the water. Yeah. Alright, I think we're just gonna go down the cave. Alright, before we go down any further, let's check this out. I'm a bit terrified. This one seems a bit more right. Oh, I can take this. Oh, what's this? What are these? Pins of some kind? Nice. Not sure why someone didn't just take him off to begin with, but heck. I'll go solve some mysteries while I'm trying to figure out who the fuck I am. It's fine. Am I gonna make shit worse for myself later on? Yeah, I mean, yeah. But, you know, it's fine. It's fine. That's how things usually go, yeah? I am enjoying this game, though. It is... It's very nice. This is very well done. Oh, nice. Another axe. Oh, I guess I can't take this one. Oh, now what? Alright. There you go.
If I am not mistaken, this relief depicts the overgrown flora we came across at the various points in the cavern can be cleared away with an iridescent device, a tool or a talisman. Curiously, we still haven't been able to find the roots of those plants. They seem to seep out of these caverns by passing through crevices which look as if intentionally made for them.
Couldn't tell you.
What other secrets might these silent halls conceal from us?
A lot. I feel like we barely even scratched the surface here, especially if we're combining lizard men with... Oh, he put on a little cloak. That's kind of cool. Wait. Well, that's weird. Is this a procession? Interesting. Can I, not this way. Alright. I can go around over here. Say I try to keep my stamina up, but I don't know. Oh god, here we go again. Alright, what's going on over here?
As we planned, my team will continue exploration through this gateway. Other expedition parties can commence when ready.
But... Okay. It's really closed off. So you probably died in there. Or did touch something you weren't supposed to as well. Why is that here? Alright, in all sense of the, is this right here is not one a Lovecraft thing. Two, it is kind of like a protection / warding sign. And it's not even any kind of protection. You can't really get any kind of full protection in this kind of universe. It's more along the lines of just like in invisibility, like, oh yeah, like when Frodo Baggins kind of falls to the ground kind of thing. This is a mistake. What the fuck is that? Oh, it's light, okay. So it's not even a full protection, it's not even a warding, it's not even really anything, it's just keeping things hidden. Which, you know, would be kind of cool. But I think it's more meant as a sealant. Oh hell yeah, give me that fucking staff, baby. Oh, this is a wheel. This isn't a staff. Oh shit. How did you get here? Can I move or... Oh, shit. Listen, listen. Can I close this? Fucking hell. I don't know what the fuck that was. Is that what that becomes of the lizard people after they eat the flower or something like that? I couldn't tell you. I know they're kind of mixed matching here, so... I mean, don't get me wrong, I do enjoy it, like... I don't understand why this is here, but... Oh, god damn it. I have no idea. Do we have some sort of, design close by? Is that a crank? I'm spinning the crank. What'd the crank do? Interesting. I was hoping it light up. Alright. Can I spin this bubble again? What the fuck is it doing? Team came in and unburied everything, which, you know, would not surprise me. Unfortunately, it doesn't look like there's anything in these. What the fuck is this? Hold up. Let's get some crouching going on over here. Hell yeah, get the fuck out of my way. I found it first.
Set of symbols we've seen in strangely carved niches all around here. Matches with what is written in the oldest parchment.
Right.
I believe uncertainly that they represent a destination towards somewhere significant.
Dun. Big dot. Wow, look at that. Me and my shitty ass drawings. I hate whatever is happening behind me. Just gonna ignore it, yeah, that's how that works. If you don't see it, it's not happening. Alright, then we got those weird ass fucking lines. Boom. Just don't do it. Just don't fucking do it. I'm gonna write this down real quick. Just in fucking case. They're like, oh yeah, no, you have to follow the right orientation as well. So just give me 2 more seconds here. That's, well, good enough. Copy down the glyphs. Fuck you. I copied him down better than you did. Oh, I see. I'm supposed to spin the wheel after I get it correct. Oh, that's why I wasn't doing nothing. Alright. Is this? Alright, whatever. Anyways, you here. Let's see, you here, sun. Oh my god, is it really just in clock? Oh my god, are you kidding me? I'm gonna go step on this thing over here. Should probably be fine. Yeah, look at that. See? Does it rotate? Alright. But you've got lights here. So why did you seal it back up? Oh my god, are you kidding me right now? What the fuck? Oh, I can see myself. Oh, yep. So that thing did look like me.
For a moment, I thought my reflection in the mirror was about to talk. For a moment, I thought I saw a light on my brow. I felt a strange crawling sensation in my wrists when I touched this black mirrored surface. And I thought I saw a light glowing on my forehead. For
okay,
a moment,
yeah,
I
that's
thought
fair.
My
that's
reflection in the mirror was about to talk to me.
Why can't I pull up my, glove? Huh, interesting. Alright. Guess we're going down. Fucking now what? Oh.
Frank, can you hear me?
Yes.
Oh, thank God. Yes, I can hear you.
Finally. You seem the effect of the mixture starts to wear off.
Oh,
Frank, boy. Heed me carefully. Time is running out. So I must be brief. Where exactly are you?
Dr. Faust, is that you? I'm inside the caves below the base. Where are you?
Listen, I cannot talk much. I know that you are having trouble remembering, but you must keep going. Use one of the submarines and follow the light.
Interesting. Am I still dead?
Do you hear me? Come on, please.
Is that why I'm not really running into anything?
Damn it! The connection is lost.
Yeah, no, there's
Instead, I have to keep going. Why? Where are
Do you really have any other choice right now? Anyways, see, there they are. See, there's little eyeballs on each of the points. See, I'm not crazy. You're crazy. Is it possible to assume that due to volcanic activities in the Earth's crust, the climate here is humid and temperate? My brain. Well, we don't know if that is the case. That theory somehow explains the nature of those small scattered fragments of obsidian along with that cryptic stone wall that welcomes you when you're entering via the round gates. As men of science, we cannot fully grasp most of the phenomena happening around us. No apparent sign has been left behind, indicating the true motives of the carvers of these inconceivably old caverns. All I am sure of is that this place holds something strange. Grasping the soil here firmly in both hands gives me a rudimentary sensation I cannot translate into words. Something I'm sure no other mortal man has hitherto perceived. Interesting. Were those maze-like tunnels flooded at some point in time, or were they carved underwater? This was the main topic of debate at last night's meeting, and what Dr. Faust hinted at on various occasions, cited from a dark leather-bound book, was too frightening. Oh my god, that must be the book from the other mission. Oh god. The Mountains of Madness book. Let's see, where was that? At least for the ones who could understand the underlying links. The megalithic statues, ornate standing stones in the flat areas of polished rock we could see at some points made us think that this place could be a religious temple complex of some sort. We cannot imagine what it looked like in its former days, for now it lies in ruins, bare, and without any sign of underwater fauna or flora. Last one here. We finished tweaking the submarines one last time, and again, they are ready enough for the next uncertain voyage ahead. This time, we will also mark the way with light sources to make it easier for later expeditions. Or me. In a short while, all members of the primary underwater exploration party, led by Dr. James Barlow, will head for the next destination, which appears to be towards the mythical entrance to the legendary netherworld. But again, I wonder whether we are looking for something that is not to be found. After all, I've experienced, read, and studied here. After all those sleepless nights spent discussing the laws of nature and how to bend them, what lies beyond, and how to reach a certain state to see more without eyes. Even I cannot help but think this journey may easily lead straight to hell. But we will go straight through it, all in search of answers. Dr. Morgan C. Blake. I'm not, not against you there either. Why do you think I'm here? What is this? Torch. It's really the torch, though. I think mine's a bit better. Okay, so he wants me to keep going forward to the submarines. I'm not too happy about it, but I don't really think I have any kind of choice. But I'm also excited to go on the submarine. So, is there one that I can pick? No, I have to go on this one. Alright, we'll go on this one then. Would you like to get on the submarine? I haven't found any other keys. Can't exactly go backwards. I'm assuming this is moving towards the end. Not exactly sure what else I would find back at base. So, let's move forward. I have no idea where his key is. We've been through everywhere. I might have missed something and been a big dumb like that before. Do I get to control the ship? Oh my god. I love the nice cushion going on here. Look around. Move forward. Move backwards. Steer left. Steer right. Ascend. Descend. Oh, hell yes. Fuck yes. Alright, what do we got? Hell yes. Oh god, that's fucking fantastic. Let's keep going. Yeah. Should I be going down? Left control is descend. Should I be descending here? I believe so. We'll find out. Interesting. I don't know where I'm going. It said there were lights somewhere. Is that one? Okay. It goes like, okay, so I'm assuming that was probably the first one, so I'll probably do a turn around over here. Big turns. Turn this down a bit so we can Oh, I can reverse too. I don't want to go too far. Alright. Where was this light? Oh, there you are. Move forward. Oh, there we go. There it is. Move ahead half speed. I enjoyed that so much. I'm assuming we're not too far underwater. That pressure would be a thing. But we are also... Oh, that's cool. But they've also been there before, so... Frog people. Let's dive a little bit more. God, this is fantastic. The amount of times I've used a fucking submarine, been able to steer a submarine in game, I can fucking count on one hand. Check this out. I know that that's over there, but very cool. Gonna thread the needle here, boys. God, this is fantastic. I thought this was just gonna be a simple walk through the Antarctic. No, that was a fucking lie. Despite being an older game, this is still so fucking cool. I don't know how you're getting radio signals to me right now, but whatever. Should I go faster? Oh good, autosave. Great. Oh cool, where I point. What the fuck does F do? I still have no idea what that fucking does. You just hear a paw, paw. Now let's slow down so I don't hit this fucking thing. One of these frog statues. I don't know what those are either. I mean, obviously I can guess, but like I said, the book never came this far. This is nuts. cool. I just can't get over the fact that I'm fucking in a submarine. Not only that, do I get to fucking pilot it. It's fucking great. Alright. Hold up. Let's go around these. I don't know what they are, but... I'm not a fan. Easy peasy. Uh-oh. I didn't fucking touch him. What is that? Right. Guess we'll go die then. Oh yeah, just as a step back, the same kind of thing appeared in the book as well. The thermal temperatures being like underground so far, and the magma and everything around keeping everything in a nice warm temperate area. Also came up in the book, but I believe it's also kind of like the same theory of like journey to the center of the earth kind of thing, you know. Of course, it's not a thing. I guess I'll fucking die.
No.
Right. Fuck. My box. What the fuck? Private rooms. Wait. What the fuck? Oh, was I literally not supposed to die there? Huh. And these are like the save areas. Okay. Interesting. I'm not sure what I want to do. I'm still interested about what's going on over here. We're running all the way the fuck back over here. No, but I went back into the private rooms, and that's where, quote-unquote, my guy's room was. And I couldn't get into it. I'll go this way.
Where am I? How did I get here?
It's definitely fair.
When?
I actually don't know where I am either. So, there's that. I guess that was just an option to go back if I really wanted to. Alright, now that it's a saving. I think I will wrap it up here for the day. So far, this game has been very amazing and just very much bringing me down memory lane when it comes to Mouse Madness, the book, and all that nonsense. And I've been having a lot of fun. And hopefully next time the conclusion will be just as amazing and mind-blowing. I'm loving this so far. And my conclusions, but we'll see how it all works out. So, as always, Thank you so much for joining me under the yellow sign. I'm glad to be back. And I hope you all have a wonderful night.